going in and I'm gonna try and knock him out. You know, I'm gonna try to do something that nobody's ever done. You know, I've sparred him before. I know exactly how to hurt him. You know, I know exactly how he gets left open. So I'm going in there. I'm going for blood every time I'm in the ring.
You sparred everybody. You sparred Kelly Pavlik.
All right, Rachel.
I'm saying you sparred everybody. Kelly Pavlik, Triple G. Who else in the champ? Alex Vosdick. You sparred heavyweights.
Sparred T. Coyote. Sparred Gabe Rosado. I sparred everybody. Golovkin was a big one. So much fighters, bro. I sparred a lot of fighters. I can't even remember.
Caleb Plant?
Nah, I've never sparred Caleb Plant. If they're in California, Las Vegas, I sparred them. So I had a lot of. I learned a lot coming up. You know, learned a lot from sparring. And, you know, I'm still learning. That's what the thing about me too. I'm not shy to watch somebody and try to learn something from them. Because, you know, at the end of the day, everybody thinks different. Everybody thinks a little bit different. So sometimes though, their headspace being a different headspace than mine. So if I watch something, you know, and I actually challenge myself to learn something different, at the end of the day, I end up winning because that makes me a better fighter.
You told me before that you don't care who wins the Canelo Plant fight. You just want to win. You really don't care. Like, doesn't matter to you.
I don't mean, I would definitely love to fight Canelo, but I mean, my main objective is to get the belt. So whoever wins the belt, that's my main objective. It's Canelo, it's Caleb Plant. It don't matter to me.
If for some reason that fight doesn't happen, like they fight and you win, they win, what would you do next? Your dad says 75 not an option yet. You say it's 68, maybe Charlo. Maybe.
I mean, if Charlo wants to come up to 68, but I don't know, man. That's the thing about it. I mean, I've been calling these big fighters out. A lot of people say that I don't bring nothing to the table. How do I not bring nothing to the table? I'm a big name, a two-time world champion. I feel like people want to see these type of fights. You know, I feel like just because it's not a Canelo, it's not worth it. You know what I mean? That's some bullshit, you know? I'd take any fight right now. You know, I'd be willing to fight anybody. And it's not because there's too much risk or anything. It's because we're already here. We're on the same level.
Berlanga, you want to fight
on the
him?
Same, yeah, Berlanga, Charlo, all we're on the same level. Why am I going to go? The only reason I fight people, not the big names, is because nobody else wants to fight. You know what I mean? So I gotta fight. You know, I can't just wait till somebody give me a fight.
But, David, that's a compliment.
Yeah, man. I just want to fight. If I'm calling you out, it's because you're the best, and I wouldn't want to fight you. You know what I mean? So,
but in the meantime, you have to stay busy. You can't wait.
And, you know, I'm nice to stay apart. You know, I want to fight the best, and I want to be the best. And I want to learn too. You know, that's my job is to learn on the job. You know, so.
What do you think of Shakur's fight? Did you watch it?
Right, it's good, bro. Shakur's fucking beast. Really good, man. It's really technical. He does everything good. Great jabs. Great body shots. He has good step backs. His footwork is amazing. He's really good, bro. I enjoy watching him.